Greetings to one and all. Today, 5th January, the Founders Day of our school. Let's have a glimpse of the life and works of our founder, Francis Xavier Crute, through this beautiful video presentation describing his journey in the service of mankind.
A great visionary and Indian missionary, founder of the Congregation of Sisters of Our Lady of Fatima. He was born on 7th December 1854 at Zwolle in Holland as the youngest and the eighth child to his parents, Henry Crute and Joanne Schroers. The constant prayers of Mr. and Mrs. Henry Crute was, "Lord, may any one of our sons be a priest to serve you." And one extra decade of the rosary was practiced during family prayer for this secret intention, that one of their children would receive vocation to priesthood. As a result, the three of their five sons became priests: Bartholomew Crute, S.J., in African mission; Anthony Crute, a Mill Hill Indian missionary; and Francis Crute, the youngest, followed his brother Anthony Crute. Two of his sisters, Adriana Maria and Anne Catherine Maria, died in infancy, while the third, Joanne Maria, expired unmarried at the age of 25. Godfrey and John stayed at home to look after the family and the shoe manufacturing business. Francis Crute joined the minor seminary at Cullimburg in April 1869 and later to Mill Hill, London, for missionary life. During his holidays, while three boys were in the seminary, they lost their beloved father in 1870. In 1873, on July 2nd, while Francis was on his home leave and as he was about to join back the seminary, his mother breathed her last. After his ordination on 9th June 1878, Father Francis followed his brother Anthony to India, fulfilling the wish of their dying mother that the two brothers work together. On 8th August 1878, Francis Crute, after a long voyage, landed at Madras seaport. Barely 24 years of age, Father Francis was appointed as the assistant parish priest of St. Mary's Cathedral, Armenian Street, Madras. He mastered Tamil and worked as chaplain at Poonamalli for 2 years. Being one with the people, he began to think of a congregation of Indian sisters early 1882. And he thought to himself, "Oh, could I build a nice convent here? It has been my all-absorbing thought ever since I came here." Transferred to Bellary as the military chaplain and reached Bellary on 9th September 1882. Bellary. This was not the picture of Bellary 124 years ago. It was known for lonely, dry, and rocky land. Of course, crowned by the magnificent Tipu Sultan Fort. Before the First World War, Bellary was an important British military station with barracks and offices for the troops in the cantonment area. When the troops left, the building remained. One of the old military church dedicated to the Assumption of Our Lady is a well-kept, spacious building. And another station, Kaul Bazaar. In September 1883, Father Francis Crute was appointed as overall in charge of 3,000 Catholics in Bellary, including St. Lazarus Church at Kaul Bazaar in Bellary. The church was built by Father Patrick Doyle, and it is the present St. Anthony's Cathedral in Bellary. Father Francis Xavier Crute encountered many spiritual, social, and moral problems in his pastoral efforts in Bellary. During his pastoral ministry and in silent prayer, he realized the importance of education for all, especially education of women and girls to change their status and to build up sound Christian families, for there was a rampant immorality and prostitution in the locality where women were given a very low status. He worked in other different mission stations in India in different capacities, such as assistant parish priest at Punamalli in Madras, provincial of Mill Hill Missionary Society, assistant to his brother Anthony Crute at Ravipadu, Guntur district in Andhra Pradesh, vice provincial, rector and professor at St. Joseph's Seminary at Nellur and Kurnool, chaplain of Fort St. George in Madras, and editor of an English weekly, The Catholic Watchman, presently known as The New Leader. June in 1886, Father Francis was appointed as the provincial of the MHMs in Madras Vicariate. 1891, he stepped down as vice provincial. While away from Bellary, he continued to prepare the soil for the seed. It was Archbishop Joseph Colgan of Madras who had the destiny of the congregation in his hands. The Archbishop gave formal permission to the request of Father Francis Xavier Crute to start the new Indian congregation of the Missionary Sisters of St. Francis Xavier in Bellary in 1892. Thus, Father Francis Xavier Crute's dream came true on 8th February 1893, when three sisters, Sister Mary Andrew, Sister Mary Anna, and Sister Mary Claire, said yes to the will of God. These sisters were kept under the care of Good Shepherd Sisters in Bellary on request by Archbishop Joseph Colgan. 29th June 1896 marked a memorable day in the history of the Indian Sisters when they were formally led to their own home, St. Francis Xavier Convent, Bellary, at Kaul Bazar. From then on, the Sisters of St. Francis Xavier began the work of education of the Indian children of Bellary. Unfortunately, Father Francis Crute had only a rare glimpse of the infant congregation as he was forced to leave India for better treatment due to his fragile health. The untimely death of Father Francis Crute left the sisters orphaned. Unfortunately, the sisters did not have any records or information about the founder for 80 long years. Daring to take leap into the unknown, the sisters faced upheavals from all quarters.